So, you want to start an urban or vertical farm? You want to transform this into this, or this, or this? Then you have come to the right place. In the next few minutes, I will explain to you why the 12 steps to become an urban or vertical farmer is the series for you. Now, I am not the expert or the professional that will be teaching you something.
Wait, what? Why are you on the screen then?
To explain this to you, I have to go back to my early years when I was playing in a hard rock band. Okay, I was not the talented musician, I was not the Jack Black that wrote all the cool music. No, my talent for the band was to bring the band together, to get us the gigs and to organize even some concerts. You could say I was the band manager.
Okay, go on.
And when it comes to urban or vertical farming, it's kind of the same. In the past years, I've been very active in two network organizations. One local, Urban Farming Ghent, and one global, the Association for Vertical Farming. And because I was involved in those two organizations, I got to know all the coolest farmers from around the world. And in that way, I will be able to help you. Because I was helping the farmers, I was kind of their assistant. I also got to ask them the right questions. And for this series, I asked them about their 12 steps to become successful in their urban or vertical farming endeavor. The 12 steps brings you the stories of the many passionate farmers who did amazing stuff. It brings you the stories of the pioneers that defied the odds and changed the status quo with every step they took and every seed they planted. They are the farmers that paved the way for urban and vertical farming to happen, and they also paved the way for your endeavor to succeed. You will learn from the best. You will learn from their successes and their mistakes. You will learn from them what to do, what not to do, what works and what doesn't work. You will be treated very nicely. What makes this series even more powerful is that you learn from farmers from all around the world, from farmers from different countries and different continents. Another strong point that's very interesting for you is that you learn from the farmers from many different industries and many different ways of growing. We interviewed greenhouse farmers, aquaponics farmers, mushroom farmers, insect farmers, vertical farmers, and we also interviewed some technology wizards. And from every case, from every farmer, there's a lot to learn and there's inspiration to find. Why? Because we went into a lot of details.
Interesting. So what kind of details are you talking about?
Well, when you start a farm, there's a lot you have to deal with. There's choosing your crops, there's the science behind growing your crops, there's the technology insight, there's the business strategy, there's the marketing, there's the legislation, there's the, you know, a lot. You could say there's 12 steps you need to take to actually start your farm. Personally, I am super grateful that we got to interview all the farmers in that much detail. Really, they gave us so much detail that the interviews were much longer than we had ever anticipated. And they gave us a lot of editing work. A lot. So, the only question that remains now is this series something for you? Well, let me ask you this. Are you passionate about urban or vertical farming? Do you want to help transform this society into a more sustainable one? And do you want to know how to start your urban or vertical farm? Well, if all answers are yes, then don't hesitate and register for this series and take your first steps into becoming an urban or vertical farmer.
Oh yeah, let's do this, that's totally me.